Hello viewers, welcome to this session on assessment and evaluation in open and distance learning system. Friends, you all know that examination is the most important activity in any university system, for that matter in college system or in the school system. Because when the students join a college or a school or a university through an admission process, then they participate in the teaching learning process. The curriculum is being transacted. And after they complete the minimum duration of the program of study, they are evaluated, which is normally called the examination process. And then the university or the college, normally the university, offers them a certificate of successful completion of the program. So today in this session, we'll discuss the entire process of assessment and evaluation in the open and distance learning system. Is it something different from a regular university system, or is it almost the same? That is a big question in our mind. At the end of the session, you will be able to know what is continuous and comprehensive evaluation, what is and how practicals are being conducted in open and distance learning system, where distance mode is the mode of teaching and learning. Can a project work be completed in ODL system? Can a student participate in seminar, workshops, group-based activities, practice-based activities? And how examination, which is normally called as the tournament examination, is conducted, and how certificates are being issued to the students? Friends, as per the regulation given by the University Grants Commission and the practice followed in open and distance learning institutions, there are broadly, you can say, two methods of evaluating the performance of the students. One is through continuous and comprehensive evaluation process, which normally is called as internal assessment in a traditional college or an university, and then the end term examination. But if there is a component of practical, like, you know, in your science subjects or in computer science or in other programs, there are practical based courses where practicals are conducted, practical sessions are conducted, and at the end of the session also practical end semester examination is conducted. Similarly, if there is a project component, the students are expected to do a project, adopting all the methodologies that are required to do a project, like identification of a topic, identification of a supervisor, then identifying the methodologies to be adopted, literature review, analysis, and conclusion. So let us start with the assignment component in open and distance learning system. Friends, assignment normally carries an weightage of 25 to 30%, varying from university to university. But every university, in every program of study, and in every course within a program, has a provision for assignments. And as per the UGC regulation, for a 2-credit course there is a provision of 1 assignment, for a 4-credit course there is a provision of 2 assignments, for a 6-credit course there will be 3 assignments, and for an 8-credit course there will be 4 assignments. But all these assignments together will carry a weightage of not more than 30%, as per the new UGC regulation of 2017. Now these assignments are basically home-based assignments, and all the questions that are being put in the assignment booklet are covered in the self-instructional material that is being given to the students. So the ideal situation is that the students will get the self-instructional material or collect it from the study centers. The counseling classes will be conducted, their doubts will be clarified, the university will upload the assignments on the website or give it to the student in the printed form, and the student will write the assignment sitting at home referring to the self-instructional materials but not copying it down from the self-instructional. They will be using their own language and they will be writing on their own, and they will submit these assignments at the study center as per the time schedule prescribed by the university, which is reflected either on the website or in the assignment booklet itself. It is the responsibility of the study center coordinator to get these assignments evaluated through the approved academic counselors. So as a counselor, your responsibility is to evaluate the assignments. Now let me tell you, evaluating the assignment is again a very challenging and interesting work for a teacher. Here, you have to go through the assignment response submitted by the learner and you have to give them marginal comment on each of the questions that the learner has attempted. And then, after the complete evaluation, based on the overall performance of the student, you have to give them global comments. So marginal comment for each question and global comment for the overall performance of the learner on the particular assignment are being communicated to the learners before the tournament examination. Either the student will come and collect the evaluated assignment from the study center, or the study center's responsibility is to send it to the student by post. So the student will get your comments and will know what are the marks given to him or her on the assignments, and based on your comments they will try to improve. But please note that those students who have done exceedingly well and have used their own language and have written in their own style, you are obviously giving them good marks because they have covered the subject, they have used the language and the style of their own. They have not copied it from the study material. You are giving them good marks or good grades. But give them encouragement in the overall comments, global comments. Encourage them and find out and highlight what are the points which you like most in the assignment response. But suppose a student who has copied it from the study material has not done that well, and you are not very satisfied, little bit dissatisfied. My request to you is, don't discourage the learner. You can use a different type of language that you, if you write in your own language, you can perform well. From the entire assignment response, I could see that there is scope for improvement, and I expect you to improve your language, your style in the next assignment response, and all the very best. So please give them some inspirational comments, motivational comments, encourage them to perform better. Don't give them any hollow comments or negative comments. Your comments should be matching with the marks or the grades that you have awarded. Suppose you have given 90 marks to a student and you say in a social science subject that your performance is not good and there is lot of scope for improvement, it doesn't match, your comments doesn't match with the marks that you have awarded, or if you have awarded just pass mark or less than the pass mark and say that your performance in the assignment is excellent, it doesn't match with the marks that you have awarded, the student will come and question you, or they ask the study center how these comments have been given to me. So be very careful in giving the assignment response and global comments and marginal comments to the learners. But please do remember that assignment is establishing a communication link between the evaluator and the learner. And through the assignment, try to motivate them, try to encourage them, and expect them to improve in the next submission of assignments. Next comes your project. Your role as a counselor is also involves supervision of the project work of the learners as per your specialization. The learner can approach you, or the coordinator of the study center will approach you to guide the learners, to help them in preparing their project work. So please take up that responsibility as a project supervisor and try to help the student in preparation of the project proposal. Encourage them to read the project guidelines given by the university or uploaded on the website, and also go through the project guidelines yourself before guiding the students. Honestly guide the student, ensure that they really do the project, not copy it from the internet or from other students or learners or friends, and encourage them to prepare a good project and give a certificate that it is the original work of the student when you are completely satisfied that a student has really done hard work and good work in preparing the project report. Sometimes your role will be also to act as a project evaluator. If you are a project evaluator, then you have to not only evaluate the project, you have to also conduct the bioversy for the learners. So there are different parameters for assessing the student's performance as far as the project report is concerned and as far as the conduct of bioversy is concerned. So please go through the evaluation guidelines given by the university and evaluate the projects based on the merit. Next comes the tournament examination. Your role as a counselor is sometimes you will be assigned the responsibility to work as an invigilator or an observer in the tournament examination conducted by the open and distance learning universities and institutions. Sometimes your responsibility will be to act as an examiner for the tournament examination papers. So you have to perform multifarious roles. As a counselor, you are teaching in the class or you are interacting with the learners. As a project guide, you are supervising the learners. As during the examination, you are helping the students in appearing the examination as an invigilator, as an examiner, even in practicals. Your responsibility is to act as an internal examiner, or sometimes in other study centers you can act as an external examiner. So you as a counselor is being involved in the entire evaluation process of the learners, and your evaluation capacity or expertise will help the university in assessing the students to know whether the student have really understood the learning outcomes that are prescribed in the program of study. So my request to all the counselors is to ensure that you perform your role judiciously, honestly, sincerely, as a counselor in a contact session, as a project supervisor, as a practical examiner, or as an evaluator in the tournament examination. The universities sometimes follow the same pen and paper examination. Sometimes the universities are also believing in or following the practice of online evaluation. So you should be very comfortable in both the system of evaluation. You should be very comfortable in evaluating the performance of the students through a computer screen with an appropriate software that is being provided by the university with user ID and passwords. And you should be also comfortable in adopting the traditional method of evaluating the performance of the students in the government examination. I request all of you to be discharging the sensitive work in the assessment and evaluation process of a university with utmost honesty, dedication, and sincerity. I wish you all the very best. Thank you. Thank you.